Arvind Kejriwal, Delhi Chief Minister. After ED, now the CBI arrests Arvind Kejriwal, seeking police custody of Kejriwal, as the trouble only now mounting for him. Multiple setbacks, as even before the Supreme Court has announced a verdict on his bail plea, the CBI appeals to arrest Arvind Kejriwal in the Delhi liquor policy case, saying he was part of the cabinet that approved the Delhi liquor policy, which now has been scrapped. The Delhi Chief Minister Kejriwal informed the Supreme Court that he has been formally arrested by the CBI. His counsel, senior advocate A.M. Singhvi, sought withdrawal of Kejriwal's plea from the Supreme Court. Supreme Court allows withdrawal of the petition. And now it appears Arvind Kejriwal will have to deal with the CBI arrest. It's not just the ED debating on why they want him in custody. It's now the CBI also taking him into custody. Multiple cases that he'll have to fight. Shreya Chatterjee joining us for more on that. Shreya, back-to-back setbacks for Arvind Kejriwal. This was something that was expected, though. The CBI also was probing the case. An arrest was expected, but to happen right before the Supreme Court's verdict on his bail plea is surprising.
Navila, you know, the arrest by the CBI in the liquor excise policy of Arvind Kejriwal was something that was in the pipeline, and that's something which also can be corroborated by what the CBI counsel has mentioned in the court, that in April itself they had got a permission to go ahead and question him. But remember, it was also during the same time that Arvind Kejriwal's interim bail plea was going on. There was an election that was going on, and the same reason has been cited by the CBI for waiting before coming into action. Now, why has the CBI arrested Arvind Kejriwal? First and foremost, he was a part of the cabinet which had approved the now scrapped liquor excise policy. The allegations that are there is that there were certain changes that were made in the excise policy to benefit the suitors, and in turn of that, alleged kickbacks were received. So during the COVID period, there were hasty meetings that were conducted and changes were made. The other allegation is that there was suggested that apparently there was a 7-point detail that was given from the LG office when a response was sought from the LG office on the policy. The CBI suggests that the LG office has denied that. The only suggestion that came in from the LG office was that this draft has to go through the GOM, which also did not take place. We also need to understand that so far as Arvind Kejriwal's role and the investigation is concerned, the CBI had already registered the 164 statement of C. Arvind, who was the personal secretary of Manish Sisodia. He allegedly had said that he was called in, and the initial changes of 5% was made to 12% in form of the amount that had to be received. And this alleged change was actually coming from the South lobby, for which meetings were also held in private hotels in the national capital. The Central Bureau of Investigation also suggests that they have unearthed the trail of 44 crores that was routed in the Goa elections, and this is the reason why they questioned Arvind Kejriwal first in the Tihar jail. Subsequently, when they found that his answers were not consistent, they sought for a production because it was required for a formal arrest. And then today, in the Rouse Avenue court, CBI has formally arrested Arvind Kejriwal, where they seek his police custody for further questioning and investigation.
Right. Take us through the specific angles, Shreya, on what the CBI is probing, on how they believe Arvind Kejriwal is involved in formulating the Delhi liquor policy, which has now been scrapped. We believe he was part of the cabinet that approved it, and then quickly after the Delhi LG flagged it, the policy was scrapped. But what angle are they probing? Is it money laundering or more?
Well, Navila, money laundering is something that is the jurisdiction of the Enforcement Directorate. The CBI is looking into the corruption angle, the alleged angle that suggests that bribes were received to change and manipulate a policy draft is something that is being investigated by the CBI. Now, for that, they have the statements of those who've turned approver in the matter. They have statements of C.A. Arvind, remember, who suggested that he was called in for a meeting where he was given directions, allegedly at the behest of Arvind Kejriwal, to increase the percentage from 5 to 12%. Apart from that, what the CBI suggests that they have unearthed, that it was the South Group who was actually giving the directions for their benefits. And in the reason to initiate these changes into the policy, there were kickbacks and bribes that were actually received by Arvind Kejriwal and the Aam Aadmi Party. Now, Arvind Kejriwal was a part of the cabinet that approved that policy, which is now scrapped. He's also the convener of the Aam Aadmi Party, and that is the reason Arvind Kejriwal's role needs to be investigated, is why the CBI has now arrested him. It's also important to understand that this case was first being investigated by the CBI. It was in 2022, in the month of August, when CBI first filed a case in this matter. In the subsequent follow-up investigation, the ED had also taken it up, where they were investigating the money laundering angle.
Right. Shreya, stay with me. I'm going to cut to BJP's Manjinder Sirsa joining us on the phone line. Sir, your take on Arvind Kejriwal being arrested by the CBI even before the Supreme Court hears his bail plea. The opposition continues to fire salvos at the centre, saying this is at the behest of the BJP at the centre.
See, that would not be fair to say that he has been arrested before. This case was to be listed before the Supreme Court. First of all, yesterday also I was listening to the leader of this, Sanjay Singh, the leader of Aam Aadmi Party, who is saying that we had Supreme Court se bail milne wali thi, isliye main arrest kar liya. I do not know when did this happen, the Aam Aadmi Party leader gets phone call from Supreme Court that they are granting you a bail tomorrow, first of all. I think that is totally a misleading statement. And secondly, I personally believe that no TV channel should also take this kind of a line to unethical hearing on a valid case. There are two different aspects. One thing is that ED is investigating the money laundering PMLA. ED has no right to investigate the predicate offense. The predicate offense has to be investigated by the investigation agency, may it be a state police or a CBI or a NIA or any other police authority. So the thing is that otherwise, in any case, whosoever is arrested by ED has to be arrested by CBI also, because the predicate offense is with that agency. Now, as far as Arvind Kejriwal is concerned, I think that is a good thing that at least he is arrested when he is in already in a police custody or in a judicial custody. Had he been granted a bail, definitely again CBI has to investigate the case, and they would have arrested Arvind Kejriwal. Then they would have shouted ki dekhiye ji kaisa vendetta hai ji, hamara to aadmi ji bahar aa gaya tha jail, to usko fir arrest kar liya. So this is not a different case, the same case. ED is investigating PMLA and the predicate offense is investigated by the CBI. So CBI has to take the action. And now as Arvind Kejriwal is arrested in an ED case, during his arrest only, during his judicial custody, CBI will also finish their investigation. I think that is a good part on behalf of Arvind Kejriwal. There is nothing wrong in this.
But what's suspicious, of course, is the timing. When I say suspicious, of course, it's the prerogative of the CBI as to when they complete investigation, they decide to arrest as per their will. But yet, it raises eyebrows to see that the Supreme Court is supposed to be hearing Arvind Kejriwal's bail plea today. Ideally, if the court gave him bail, he would be out. But even before that, the CBI rushes to arrest him.
So first of all, nobody can come to the conclusion that the CBI will grant him bail. I think that will be too early to comment on the CBI, on the Supreme Court. And that will not be unfair and not be legally justified. First thing. Second thing. Even otherwise, if he's granted bail by the ED court, by the CBI, or by the Supreme Court in an ED case, definitely he'll be out after we see the investigation. What a big deal. I don't understand. Though his arrest in this case, do it hampers any kind of bail matter in Supreme Court? No. Nothing will differentiate in Supreme Court whether he's arrested by CBI in this case or not. Otherwise, also, if he gets bail, he will be released in an ED case and thereafter he'll be released in a CBI case also. But the only thing is, Aam Aadmi Party, because they have no answer to this camp, they have no answer to why did Arvind Kejriwal made this policy, why this policy was drafted to give benefit to the friends of Arvind Kejriwal, why the commission from 2% was increased to 12% and 7% to 12%. What was the reason flat 12% profit was given to the friends of Arvind Kejriwal? Because Aam Aadmi Party has no answer to this question, so they are debating this break to ED, BJP, CBI, BJP ke kabje mein hai ji, CBI ne ye galat kiya, ek paisa nahi mila, so these are the only diversion tactics, nothing more than that.
All right, thanks very much, Manjinder Sirsa, for joining us on that.